Yo, what's up, YouTube? Welcome back to another video. Welcome back to the channel, man. And today is the day that I'm going to do another mod for the Camaro, man. This time, it's going to be something to help reduce weight. It's removing the passenger seat. So let's get into it. Okay, so as y'all can see, we got the Camaro in the garage, man. Apparently, to remove the passenger seat is going to be an easier job than trying to remove the back seats, man. So it only requires one tool to remove it, and that is a Torx 50 bit. I'm gonna use it with a power tool, so of course it's easier to do than try to do it the regular way. That's why I bought the tools. But yeah, that's all it takes. It's like two bolts remove the passenger seat, and that's pretty much be it. Now y'all probably asking, like, why is you removing the passenger seat already? And if y'all been following my channel in the last couple of videos, this weekend is the Tucson Dragway event, where that racing channel is coming here, and they doing a big event this weekend. So it's going to be roll racing. It's going to be drag.
The fuck is that? Shit! I'm dying in this fucking country ass fucked up town.
It's going to be roll racing. It's going to be drag racing. It's going to be a car show and everything at this drag strip. So that's why I'm taking a passenger seat out, because I am doing the roll racing event. And yeah, I feel like that's going to help my times a little bit, since I'm a manual and everything else. But it adds on to my weight reduction. And the good thing about it is, it's not going to stay like that forever, but how easy it is to remove the passenger seat, I mean, you can take it out on the weekends and install it back in on Sunday. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it is. So we're going to get straight into the install. First, what we need to do to get to the bolts that we need to just remove, like, well, this is going to take forever, but like lifting a rear back part of the seat all the way up and then sliding it forward. So see, we got this bolt that's like right there to the right that got that hex looking thing on the outside of the bar, and in the inside of the bar we have that screw right there that we need to remove. After that, that's about it. We just slide the seat back afterwards and then tilt it forward, and it should come out. And this seat here will remove about, I believe this front seat is about like 60 pounds. It all varies based on like what you have. So whether it's a leather seat or a cloth seat, all that weight weighs different. But for this particular one, I feel like it's about 60 pounds, maybe 70 pounds. All right, y'all. So as you can see, I moved that bolt out there. I moved that bolt over there. And so far when you do that, look, the seat is like ready to come out. But what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna slide it back. And then once I tilt it front, you will see why I had to slide it back, because I gotta lean it forward for it to fully come out. So behind here, this is the connector I was talking about. You got these orange tabs that you just have to lift up. Hard to hold the camera and do it with one hand, but I lift it up and then it comes out. And as you can see, it's very simple to get out. You don't have to use that much effort. I was just making sure I didn't mess up the connector, because I don't know what this go to, but I don't want to mess it up. So then, after that, I can just like take this bolt off, and then this part, and then I just string this piece. I take this bolt off, and then string this piece all the way out, and then that's it. And don't forget, like, you can use like a, like I have this like vice grip,
where I can just take this off. Because GM, for some reason, they put these, like, washers on here. They very thin. You don't really need them. So next time you go back and put it in there, you don't have to worry about this no more. Taking the bolt off, it'll come out next time. So this is a tip to remember, as you can see right there. What I had to do was I had to lean it back and then lean it forward, because you'll see these notches here. That is why I had to do that. You have those notches that's in the floor right there, as you can see in the blue. That makes it hard to come out. And this is perfect time to like clean underneath your seat too. But all I have to do now is remove this connector that's underneath the seat. And that's okay. So you guys can know what you're doing. I had to record it this way because the angle I had it, you wasn't going to be able to see what I was doing. But you got this button here. Yeah, you got this lever here. So you push this button back. When you push this button back, this you can lift this lever up all the way back. And then this harness pop out. With that being said, we can now remove the entire front seat. Also, one more thing I need to share with you guys. Yeah, that joint crazy. That joint crazy. But when you guys remove the passenger seat, you will get this service system or this check engine light or whatever. Not a check engine light, but you'll get this emblem right here saying safety restraint system. And that's because, of course, you remove that out. So nothing to worry about. And that's for my tires, because I switch it up with no tire pressure sensors. But yeah, you will get this notification here. So this is something to be aware of, nothing to freak out or whatever. But for people who don't know, figuring like, oh, I can remove my passenger seat to ride around with it, you can, but you will get like this message that bugs you every time. So something to do on the weekends, not to ride around with it every day unless this is like your actual drag car setup.
And to put it back in, it's just reversing the steps, man. It's not that bad at all. So three Torx bits and just remove the airbag connector on the outside where the seat belt is, and then the negative connector underneath where it slides the seat back and forth. And that's pretty much it, man. And before I leave this video and wrap it up, man, I just want to say again, thank you for all of those who've been supporting my merch. I believe everybody who have ordered until this point, who haven't ordered recently, like yesterday or so, all the orders has been shipped and should be delivered, man. So y'all let me know what y'all think. Go to my website and write a review on it. Be honest with me. Let me know what you think. Like that, man, I'm going to wrap this video up. If y'all like cars like these, you know, follow the MOC, man. That's me, Q the Chaotic, Race Car Friends, and the Honey Gang Nate. And like that, I'm out.